Need better writing tools? I'll reveal the hidden features inside tools you already have and some you don't that most authors completely miss. Let's start with Google Docs. While most first-time authors use it for basic manuscript formatting, it also offers helpful features that will streamline your writing process. I've shown you in previous videos how to use headings to organize your sections and chapters, but let me show you how to instantly navigate your manuscript using the outline view. Look at the left side of your screen. You see that document outline button? Click that, and now every heading you've set up within your manuscript can now be seen as an outline and is clickable. This way, you don't have to scroll through pages and pages of your manuscript, but instead, click right where you want to be. As an editor, I've seen countless manuscripts, and I can tell you that this is probably one of the most useful organization features in Google Docs. Next, version history isn't just for backups. To access it, click File in the top menu, then hover over Version History and select See Version History. And you'll be able to access previous versions of your manuscript. This is useful because you can save and label different drafts by clicking the three dots right here next to any version and selecting Name the Version. So for example, I recommend labeling significant milestones like pre-editor review or post-chapter restructure. This makes it easy to find and compare important versions of your manuscript, and you can also restore previous versions if need be. Finally, let me show you how to use the personal dictionary, a feature that's incredibly valuable for nonfiction writers. To access it, first click Tools in the top menu, then select Spelling and Grammar, and in the drop-down menu, click Personal Dictionary. A window will pop up where you can add your specialized terms. For example, if you're writing a book about digital marketing, terms like SEO, WordPress, or company names like HubSpot might get flagged as spelling errors. By adding these terms to your personal dictionary, Google Docs will recognize them throughout your entire manuscript. Now, before we move on to our next tool, stay tuned because later in this video, I'll show you my favorite way to use Google Forms, a technique that's helped dozens of my clients gather amazing content for their books. Next is Reedsy Book Editor. While Google Docs is great for drafting, Reedsy shines in formatting. Watch how it automatically handles chapter formatting. No more manual spacing or font adjustments. When my clients use this specific approach, it saves hours of formatting and you don't have to pay someone in order to do it. But here's the game changer. To export your book, click the export button on the right. You'll see some options for both EPUB and PDF formats. Before exporting, make sure to choose your trim size and a theme that works best for your book. Once you've set these options, one click gets you a professionally formatted file ready for publishing. Next up is Speechify, an app that has the capability of reading your manuscript to you. As a writing coach, I've seen authors catch countless awkward phrases and repetitive sections using Speechify, issues they'd miss during dozens of regular read-throughs. The first thing you'll want to do is head over to speechify.com and click Try for Free. Remember, there's no credit card required. It will walk you through a series of questions, and bear in mind, it's quite a few questions, but this app is typically used for people who are looking to read more. Once you get through the questions, you'll create an account. Once signed in, you can upload your manuscript as a DOCX or PDF file. Once your manuscript imports, you'll find your controls at the bottom of the screen where you can select a voice and the speed at which you like your manuscript read. I suggest this app to my clients for their final editing pass. It's like having a professional reader point out every stumble in your manuscript that you'd otherwise not hear. Now, in my previous video, I showed you how to use Google Forms for beta reader feedback, but today I want to share my favorite alternative way to use this tool, one that's helped dozens of my clients gather amazing content for their books. Now, here's a practical example. Let's say you are writing a business or professional book and you need to do interviews or get expert opinions and industry perspectives. You can easily create a Google form to capture this data. This approach not only saves you time, but it also brings diverse viewpoints to your book. And a bonus is that all of the responses are automatically organized in a spreadsheet, making it easy to sort through the data and identify the most compelling stories and insights to share with your readers. Finally, don't overlook your local library. Many offer free access to premium writing software like Microsoft Word through their computers. Even better, through your library card, you can get free access to valuable resources like LinkedIn Learning, which offers courses on writing. Some libraries even provide complimentary access to major publications like the New York Times, USA Today, and the Wall Street Journal, perfect for research and staying informed in your field. These subscriptions would normally cost you hundreds of dollars per year, but they're completely free with your library card. So take a few minutes to explore your library's digital resources page, and you might just be surprised by what's available to you at no cost. And if you're ready to level up your writing process, check out my detailed video on using Google Forms to gather expert content. It's the exact process I use with my coaching clients. And check out my next video where I'll share my secret system for staying organized while writing your book.